So what do you think your dad does on the AFI board? What do you think his responsibilities are?
I think he goes to a lot of meetings.
A lot of.
And usually he buys stuff for us. He is pretty much the boss of the thing.
So on our first date, Jeff was coming straight from a fraternity meeting. We were meeting for a drink and I was waiting for him in the lounge at the Arizona Inn in Tucson. And when he walked through the door, I stood up to introduce myself and to shake his hand. And he didn't shake my hand, he came over and gave me a hug. And that's when I knew that he was a good guy.
He is genuinely a nice guy. He cares about people. He's interested in doing what he can to help others.
His clients feel like they're part of his family and like he really cares about what they want and their goals. And I've sort of become part of that as well through working with him. He's really taken an investment in like my future and my career.
I love my dad because he is really awesome. He lets me watch Clone Wars with him. He helps me with my homework, and he's just awesome as dad.
AFI did a tremendous amount for me, for my nephew Corey, for my brother who's now an honorary initiate, and I want to make sure that my kid, if he wants, has the experience that is there for him, and that I leave it better than when I came in.
He takes Tikkun Olam, the concept of repairing the world and really being there for his fellow people and helping people through tough times, he takes that to heart. And I think that's what he gets out of his involvement.
AFI is a second family to Jeff.
Dad tickles my feet when we're playing Tickle Monster. That's why I love him.
He is very committed to helping people. For example, he helped launch the Wheels for Heroes program in Arizona, and that program has achieved national success.
So I grew up in New York City. I worked with my father in the towers, and I was living here in Tucson when the towers went down after 9/11. And I wanted to do something to give back to the people who, you know, the 343 firefighters that died from FDNY, the 23 police officers from NYPD. I wanted to give back.
And he got a group of attorneys together to help provide free wills and estate planning documents for any first responder and their families.
I started it in Arizona. We were the third Wheels for Heroes program around the country, but the first to really develop it in a way that can be replicated in other places. And we're now in 27 some odd states. We've done over 60,000 estate plans around the country, and the program just keeps growing and growing.
And the fact that Jeff has made it such a personal passion project of his to go out and help these people across the country is really something special.
Jeff's the kind of person who steps to the plate and does what needs to be done, and we're lucky to have him as a member of our community.
Mazel tov, Daddy!
He just loves me so much. As you can see.